AI scientist Evelyn from the California Science Center, here to help you feel a little less stuck at home. And welcome to my lab. Well, you know, welcome to my home. Same thing. This week, we are exploring chemistry, and today, we are having you explore a mixture that has lots of small particles floating within that mixture, and then it behaves very, very strange. We call it Oobleck, and maybe you've heard of it, maybe you've read it in a book, maybe you've made it in the past. We want you to play with that today. Now, like I said, this mixture has tiny particles in between it, and it makes it behave very differently. But before we go into that, I want to show you something else. So here, I have this file, lots of little iron filings in it. When I put a magnet to it, you'll see that I can play with those, and they're attracted to the magnet. If we take these iron filings and cut them up, and make them even smaller, and put them into another liquid, like oil, the liquid can vary, it'll end up looking a little something like this. As I move that around, you can see that it still behaves like a liquid. I can pour it, I can move it. Same thing, when I apply that magnet, it then behaves once again like a solid. Now there is a word for things that behave like a liquid and a solid, and we call that a non-Newtonian fluid. So Oobleck is another example of a non-Newtonian fluid. This is what we call ferrofluid. Now, once we reopen, you are welcome to head over to Creative World in the Science Center, and you'll have a chance to play with some ferrofluid. You can make comparisons to the three different types we have there and see which one works best. Now, scientists do use ferrofluid all the time. They use it in MRI scans to get a better picture of what's happening inside of your body. Sometimes you can find it inside of speakers so you can get better sound. But enough of playing with this one. How do we make Oobleck at home? You'll need something to pour it in, like a container. You need some cornstarch and some water, and ideally something to mix it. So in this case, I used about 1/4 of a cup of cornstarch and about 5 tablespoons of water. I also added some food coloring. You can see it on my fingers. And I mixed all of that into a container. Now, playing with this can get kind of gross and kind of messy. You can see that I have something out to keep that mess under control. And I decided to use my chopstick to mix it all up. Now, when I put pressure on this, you can see that it's kind of rough. But if I just let my chopstick hang in there, and it goes into the fluid. I can probably show you a little bit better if I take my zebra. So my zebra can walk across it, but it can also sink into it. And like I said, it gets really messy. Now, scientists, if you haven't already, go check out our website, download our sheet, make your own Oobleck at home, mess with that recipe a little bit, see what you can learn. Now, thanks again for stopping by. If you want to explore more non-Newtonian fluids, ketchup is another one you can find in your kitchen. Thanks for stopping by, scientists. I hope you're feeling a little less stuck at home, and see you next time.
Be sure to visit our website Monday through Friday at 10 a.m. for more stuck-at-home science activities.